Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and those of you who don't know what the hell you are yet. Hop along, PR here. We are back playing Legend of Heroes, Trails of Cold Steel 2, and me and the princess, we were making like a couple of leaves and getting the fuck out of here.
There are a lot of very strong people here, so try to keep your voice down.
Not to worry.
He's not there. But she's right there. What's up? Good day, Princess Alphen. And now Master Reen, was it? Yeah, that's me. She's always been someone rather special to me. Now we've enjoyed our fateful reunion with one another, I wish never to be parted from him again. She wants this poor maid to take things the wrong way. Is that so? My, how wonderful. Edgy, you don't mean to press on to why he's rather special to you? Quite the contrary. I would prefer such pressing on if you don't mind. Although the answer would be all but obvious with little thought. Oh my.
You know, I could go through the passageway. Or... Oh. Did you look at that? There happens to be a vent here.
This looks like... Thought so. It's a vent. Well, that's convenient. Might lead somewhere else on the ship, don't you think?
Most likely, but still. Can't very ask a princess to crawl through a vent.
Nonsense, Reen. Of course you can. I'm ready to begin our great escape. It's gonna be all dark inside and probably filthy, too. A little bit of darkness and dirt never hurt anyone. I had to travel through some fairly narrow underground passages when escaping through Heimdall, too. Alright, how about I go first? Smaller than you, after all.
No, definitely not.
Well, as long as you're right with it, I'll be going first. Like I said before, just stay close to me. All right, then. You think a princess would be more mindful when she's wearing a dress?
Yeah, you'd think so, but no, no. She is a brilliant... Wait, she's brilliant, so she probably would have teased me about it.
It's not dirty at all in here.
Maybe it's Ouroboros. Fuck it, I'm saying it forever. Ouroboros is going just all out with their housekeeping. I really appreciate it. They do everything. Murder, sabotage, terroristic reform. You name it, they do it. House cleaner. Yeah, we can see that for Sharon. They make nothing but the best. If at nothing else, they'll end up being, you know, a brand of something. Huh. If you guys all saw something branded Ouroboros, how fast would you buy it? And how much money would you be willing to pay for it? It depends on the item. I think my limit might be $70. Seems like the right cutoff point of like, too ridiculous. Anyway, here's hoping we can make it to the deck without getting caught. Speak of the devil. Those are coming this way. Keep a safe distance and let me handle this. Feels like the closest thing we have to someone ordinary is that kid. Pretty nerve-wracking having to be all around them all. Just wish I'd get to see Princess Alphen in person. Oh? What? Too late. Okay, that was an awesome strike.
Here I go.
Okay.
Really? Whatever it is I learned isn't popping up anywhere. This is a load of horseshit. Unless it's... No, it wouldn't be a 200 only. That'd be cool if it was. I don't know. I doubt it, but it would be a nice touch if they did.
That's that. Let's keep moving.
Poor chumps. Never had a chance. Okay, Tira Bomb.
Hmm.
They're strong.
You all right, Uranus? Yes, I'm fine, thank you. Let's be going. I'll sure stay very close to you.
All right, here we go. Okay, I don't know if you guys can hear it or not, but there is a train going in the background of my recording, but that train whistle or train horn, whatever you want to call it, is just very, I don't know, it's nostalgic for me because my town is very well known for trains, so trains are going all the time pretty much. And even had a home that was close to a set of railroad tracks, and at all hours, there'd be trains going. I don't know when it happened, but it stopped being like annoying to me, and it actually started to become soothing. Because there's something about like the droning on of the tracks that's kind of, oh, running on the tracks, that's kind of,
Let's move.
I can't describe it. It's relaxing.
Huh. It's my turn.
Okay, what? Nope. Ooh. Oh. You've got the good shit on you. Been holding back this entire time. Okie dokie.
Let's move.
Ooh. I didn't see what weapon she had.
Let's move. Sit.
Or even if she has a weapon. She doesn't have a weapon. She doesn't even have crafts. No craft macaroni. That is truly harrowing. Wind.
Arcus, activate!
Yeah, come on. Hooray! Azreen eats a bullet sandwich.
My turn.
And boink.
We'll cut our own path.
Yes, we will. Also, she's pretty strong for a little kid. Level 60.
Are they mechanical monsters?
Yep.
They're called archaisms.
And they're just pretty par for the course around here. Trust me, you'll get used to seeing them. Ooh. The best stuff to have is always in the enemy bases. They have all the coolest shit.
I don't suppose escaping through the windows would be an option.
Nope.
Probably not. We'll have to do this the long way.
Orange cape. Mine. Taken from the enemy. How rude of me. Oh well. All's fair in love and war. And there is a war going on. Lest we forget. Cool.
Good luck, Green.
Oh, God. There are so many of them. I was not prepared for this. Repeat, I was not prepared.
Fall! Now's our chance.
Cool. What? What? Can't you do that all the time?
Here I go.
I was ready for this after all. What'd you know?
It's my turn.
My turn.
Bye, dude. Ah, he's sticking around.
My turn. Sit.
Green.
Right.
Ooh. Yeah. Goodbye.
My
farewell.
Turn.
Auf Wiedersehen, adieu.
Ha. Now.
But that was no. I was in that.
You're finished.
I will say that was the one school play that I wasn't a part of. Oh my god. I fear these words being said on the internet. So I'm going to be using it in very specific context so it can't be taken out of context in any way, shape, or form. When I was a part of the musical, The Sound of Music, I had a stand-in role as an extra. That extra being Nazi. So I had to stand in and be one of those said things at the very end of the musical. And I fell for some, I don't know, whatever their trick was to escape. I was the dumb one. I'll happily be a dumb one of those. You know, I prefer not to be one in general, but hey. You gotta do it for the theater. It's art, after all. Not to mention, you know, at the time I'm recording this, I think just like the aftermath of the PewDiePie nonsense is finally almost over. Two soldiers, one military monster. Shouldn't be a problem. Stay back, please. Right. Hey, I remember something like those in the sewers. Must be the little younger, inferior brothers. All right, so it's not my S-craft, so what the fuck did I learn? That'll probably tell me. No, I think. Yeah, I think I'll save it. I am getting close to the boss. I would. Oh, fuck.
Lovely.
Yeah, they're going to be targeting only Rain. Oh god, I am so happy I'm healing. Yeah, Rain. What? Thought that cured everything but KO. Yeah, nope.
Right.
You are bringing him back so he can finish everything off.
Thanks.
In a very Goku-esque fashion. You know, coming in right at the last moment before things get too bad. I essentially just gave him a Senzu Beam. Senzu Beams were the major because fuck logic thing in that. Well, I should say second. I think the first thing is the power levels.
That's the power
because it was done fantastically, but not a lot of people understood that when they started the power level things. It was just purely for a joke.
Well.
I think people believed it for a while, but then they came around back to being, nah, they're just fucking with us.
I'm shocked how skilled
yes.
you are with arts.
Are you,
you
witch
are?
By chance?
You're so sweet.
And again, she is Oliver's sister, so gotta be something there. Hello, housekeeping. You decent? Oh, you busy. I come back never. I don't want to talk to you, Mr. Huge Arm Robot Dude. Just imagining those things are his arms. Fuck. Fine.
Good luck, Rain.
Come at me, bro.
Let's move.
Huh. Never a bad idea to get a buff. And come on.
Gladly.
Wait. Okay, cool. Ooh. Yes, please. Yes, please, indeed.
Let's move.
Okey-dokey.
Burn to ash.
See how you like this.
Now.
Rush him. What was that noise?
Too slow.
Please don't do anything.
My
yes.
Sit. Now's our chance.
Hooray.
You're finished.
I did it. Yes, and I have 200.
Your Highness.
Ooh. I want to use those so badly. I haven't had a chance yet.
Oh, look! A staircase!
Hopefully this will lead to the deck.
Well, seeing as there's a normal changing station here, I'd say it either does and leads to a boss fight, or it doesn't and leads to a boss fight. Either way, you know what's coming up next. All right, so give me one moment. I need to tweak a few things to make sure everything goes all right. I'll tell everybody that I did not forget, and that Lord Mishi has finally infiltrated the royal family. Oh, yes. I seized this opportunity, and I took it. Soon, Erebonia will be under Lord Mishi's control. Neither Ouroboros nor the church can save them from Lord Mishi's wrath. Okay, so before we could do that, you know, let's escape off the ship. Might be a decent idea. Just throwing that one out there. Okay, knock knock. Who wants to play? Crow, are you here?
How did you get ahead of us?
I'll freely admit I wasn't actually expecting you to join the Alliance.
But we can't have you escaping from them. Nay, I must gaze upon thine beauty every single day. Be it alive or dead.
But not even in my wildest dreams did I imagine you'd try to flee the ship with our dearest princess.
Yep.
You're a bold one, I'll give you that.
Well, yeah. Not me, then who?
I wasn't expecting to run into either of you on the way out either. You guys aren't called the Phantom Thief and Dubily the Swift for nothing.
Trying to praise us won't get us to let you pass.
Never hurt.
Princess Alfin is one of this nation's most precious treasures. You surely couldn't have thought that I, the Phantom Thief, would allow you to steal her from us, could you?
Well, yep.
I'm not being stolen by anyone. If anything, I was the one who whispered sweet nothings into his ear and tempted him to run away with
me.
Oh my, what a passionate young lady you are.
Does that add to her beauty?
You've no doubt taken after your brother in more ways than one.
Thank you.
I'd like to believe that I'm not quite the oddball he is.
Oh, come on.
I agree more with his belief that love is the truest form of beauty, however.
Uh-oh.
Really now?
They're actually hitting it off.
Yes, they are.
I think that's enough messing around for one day.
Oh, you're no fun, you're Killjoy.
You're a enforcer, Blue Blanc. Take your work seriously and behave!
But why?
I think the number of enforcers who take things seriously are in the minority, I'm afraid.
Yeah, actually, that's pretty true.
You're right about us having played around for long enough. I find the many mysteries surrounding you fascinating, but there's a certain appeal to them remaining forever unsolved, too.
Whatever you gotta tell yourself, dude.
You may think yourself a swordsman, but allow me to show you how little you truly know.
Sure. I'm sorry. Her character design reminds me a lot of Estelle.
I'll be fine. Don't worry about me. The gap in
I don't know why. Just like
small enough that I should be able to
brown hair and then
away.
The hair thing. Yeah. You get it.
Oh.
Small? The difference in our strength is like night and day, you boor. And if you're foolish enough to be unable to see that, then allow
can I please
me to
go Super Saiyan Rain on them?
And pay for your-
the one being foolish and arrogant is you.
Really? Oh, I am.
My, my.
Rain?
I owe me being able to do this to you, Your Highness. You and Elise. No. Everyone who's done anything to aid us in coming this far deserves
hooray!
This.
Hooray! Yay!
What's happened to him?
Could the
this be your ogre power?
Is it ogre? I like Super Saiyan or even Demon better.
8 leaps, 1 blade school, intermediate level. I, Rain Schwarzer, will be your opponent.
Yeah!
Yay!
I will enjoy this.
This is his ogre power?
My turn.
Ooh. I like all these words. They have fatal, fatal, arcane, and fatal. Oh, and I have permabuffs. Or at least for one turn.
Burn to ash.
I have to see all these. Even if they're just only minorly different. Yes, yes, yes. Ooh.
Can't hit ship it!
Ooh.
Come, my minions!
Minion up here.
Here I go!
Ooh. I haven't done that one. I think that's it. Oh, I remember this attack.
Here I go.
Okie dokie, give me that.
Marcus, activate me. Yeah!
Hooray! Alright. Now I imagine that I only have to do so well against these guys.
Can't even hit what's right in front of you. Wow.
Come on, hit me. Yes.
Gather on my blade.
Ooh, I ended it. Oh yeah, I'm saying this now and forever. I will never call this power Ogre Power. I will always refer to this as Super Saiyan.
Splendid, simply splendid. So you finally conquered your power yes. And made it your own, did you?
I made this bitch mine.
Rain.
Forgive me, Your Highness.
What for?
Bah, bitch! Oh my god! I have the Wooshy Woosh power now!
Wait just a damn minute!
Ha! I have the Wooshers! Going on here? Don't know, but I think it's worth chasing after them.
Yes. Very much so.
Make our way directly to the deck. Are you all right, Your Highness?
Yes, perfectly.
Oh.
My heart just feels as if it's about to burst.
That doesn't sound very fun.
Come on, is now really the time to be flirting with each other?
Crow. Nope, Jaegers.
You're here too.
Of course.
You got some real guts, kiddo. But you ain't getting past us.
Zephyr's guard shall not be easily broken.
Oh, there it is. This is so cool.
Looks like he's picked up a few tricks from our feet.
Yes.
The targets have broken our line of defense. Commencing pursuit.
You know, I think I might just give Rain, you know, like all the time in the world that he needs if I just keep you right here.
Yeah, certainly. Certainly.
He's got about like what, half a minute head start now? Ah, that's good enough. It did him plenty favors.
I'm sorry about that, Your Highness.
I'm fine. Don't about me. Can I hold on to you a little
yes.
longer?
Yes.
Of course.
Probably good timing, too.
Target's in sight. Commencing capture. My suspicions outlining you as an indecent person seem to have been confirmed.
You not make me out to be some kind of pervert all the time, please?
Oh, come on. Somebody's got to do it to somebody. Stell's not here, so somebody has to pick up the slack. Oh. Get out of my house. Well, technically your house.
Target lost. I may have underestimated you, Rene Schwarzer.
Just
in more
a little
ways
bit.
Than one.
I'm so sorry, Your Highness. I didn't really have any choice but to do that. I realize that's no excuse.
I know you didn't. But she seemed even younger than me.
Yes, she was.
That truly is indecent.
Okay, so who do we still have to see? Nick Byrne.
The exit.
Don't change the subject.
Nick Byrne should have been there. He might be here, but don't know. I doubt mirror change is enough to keep
That's
Valimar.
The Ashen Knight? Isn't that?
There we go.
Crow. And.
Yep. I'm gonna need to take this one on.
Huh. So that's how it manifests for you.
Mm-hmm.
You finally mastered that power you got, huh? Still. You're one busy guy, you know that?
Yep.
1 minute you're down in the dumps, the next, you've got one of the cutest girls in the country cheering you up.
You jealous?
Well, I can't deny it, but she wasn't the only one. It was my sister, classmates.
I really wonder what the actual Crow is.
Come on.
Can't say I'm not curious to see what that power of yours can do, but I think you get priority here.
Yep.
Yeah, let me have this one.
Nope. I'll outclass you on the ground.
Don't mind.
All right.
This is your first time fighting me without the mask on, I think.
Yep.
With our divine knights, I come out on top.
Let's see how I fare on the ground.
When it's just the two of us.
Sounds good to me.
Just the two of us.
You managed to win against three of us at
we
once.
We can make it if we try. Just the two of us. That's all I know.
And this time, I'll be the victor.
Go ahead and try.
Yes, I will. The two character models just flying at each other just look hilarious. Like, I'm imagining it completely out of context. There is no battle going on. It's just the two lifeless character models going. Okay.
Marcus, activate. Yeah.
I have the cosmic knowledge now.
Gotcha.
Missed me, bitch.
My turn.
Oh, it's time to take you on a slow boat to China, Crow.
My turn.
There we go. I was paranoid that I wasn't gonna get it. Can you blame me? I doubt I have much room for error in this fight. Beautiful.
Not bad.
Criminal Edge.
My turn.
What kick?
Activate.
Probably should have done this first. Oh well.
Here we go.
I think, yeah, it is.
Let's move.
My primary strategy with Rin always boils down to one thing. Get him to 200 CP as fast as possible. And that's why I have the gladiator headband on him, and Impassion, and his master quartz. All of these are reasons.
My turn.
Come on.
Here we go. Eat this. Too slow. Here we go.
Let's see. Get in one.
Let's move.
Two.
Here we go.
Two more before I could have to let you hit me. Lord Mishi, your boon is great, and I appreciate it. Oh. I wonder if I can mix this power with Valimar's. Is Valimar even going to be part of next game? I don't know, I guess. Play deck two? Ah! It's like he knew what I wanted for Christmas. Yay. Well, it is December, so yeah. It is the season.
You actually did it. I sure yes. wasn't expecting you to beat me one-on-one.
Oh, you weren't alone, Crow.
You fought pretty well yourself. Couldn't have been easy to last as long as you did against me like this.
And there's your limit.
Rin!
Hooray!
Why did this have to happen now?
Defeat!
Guess your luck ran out.
Yep. Valimar, anytime. I sincerely doubt that those chains are really enough to contain Valimar.
Slightly too reckless this time.
That wasn't a bad fight. Mm-hmm. Even if you lost, at least you tried, I guess.
Really? Is that what you have to say? I swear to God, if you're my father.
Your Highness, please move away from me.
Hey, don't be too rough with... Look sharp!
Is he... Ah! Ah! It's about damn time!
The Crimson Wings?
Yep. The prince is back in town, bitches. Hooray! Did you guys see how cool I was?
What are you all...
Sorry for the wait, Rin.
It's about damn time.
Yo, we're here to save the day.
You caught us all off guard back in Ymir.
So this time we opted to take the initiative ourselves.
Repay the favor.
We meet again, Severing Chain.
McBurn is just such... I can't stop thinking about McBurn. No, but... Okay. I'll admit that I've been, like, holding off on looking up anything on the wiki that is no doubt in my mind on the internet for more of these, like, character backgrounds.
She brought more than that. Check out the Icy Maiden and that Big Shot Arts user from the Bracer Guild.
We couldn't ask for a more impressive. However...
Where's Class 7
here
at?
It comes again.
I count our save!
Your lordship.
Uncle Victor.
Yay.
He is here to fuck shit up, ladies and gentlemen.
It's good to see you again, Rin. And it relieves me to see you're none the worse for wear, Your Highness.
Did anybody see me be cool with my powers? No? Fuck.
Huh. Well, you're strong. Very strong.
Yes, I am.
That's quite the nod coming from the Blazing Demon himself. I can see now why you're considered one of the fiercest in the Ouroboros. An Why some even claim you to be the Steel Maiden's equal.
Interesting.
Well, I know who I'm gonna be fighting.
Don't you go forgetting about us now.
Are
you all here too?
Are you okay, Reen?
Yep.
Looks like we've landed in the middle of something pretty crazy.
Pretty much.
And not a moment
at least
too soon.
Now we have the numbers.
You came!
I'm glad to see you're all right.
Olivert, we say,
you kept yourself busy. Enjoying your scandalous elopement with Reen, are you?
He gave me the time of my life. You guys were having that much fun, huh?
And with our princess, Reen.
I think we were so worried about you.
You're not supposed to take it literally.
So this is what you threw me out of Valimar for? Doesn't look very fun.
Sup, dudes?
You're here.
It feels like it's been ages since we last saw you.
You're looking spiffy, Crow.
He is, actually. Rather dapper, young gent.
Sure wasn't expecting all of you to show up, though. How are we even gonna settle this?
That is the question, isn't it? I'd roughly estimate both sides to be of equal strength.
Yeah? We'd probably just end up at a stalemate, huh?
No, just give Reen, like... Does anybody have a spare Zerum powder? Give him one of those and he'll perk right back up.
Doesn't sound like much fun at all. Let's say we just forego the fighting and have ourselves a party instead.
Yes.
I could never turn down a party.
Yes! Yeah! Forgot Blue Bug was here.
That sounds simply wonderful.
I'll bring the booze.
Why don't you take this a little more
seriously? Nope.
This is getting us nowhere.
Wait. Okay. Sorry. There's one other bird.
Look who
that I know
decided to show up.
That can be a part of any game.
Krianos, Vita.
Yes, dear sister.
Welcome aboard the Pantagruel, Emma.
So, actually, Vita, I have a question that you might have the answer to. So, yeah, are all witches naturally well endowed, or is it magic? Because I'd believe either.
Your overall
to be completely
as a witch
honest
might still be lacking, but that transportation spell was exceptional.
Oh.
I must apologize for the untimely intrusion. As displeased as a few of you might be by the idea, I think it best if we let one another peacefully go our separate ways.
I wanted to see the Blade Master against the Blazing Demon.
I'll be the one who bears the brunt of Duke Cayenne's anger.
Papa Arsade.
Vita.
Can't say I understand why we should.
It's not our place to question the orders of our clients.
Exactly.
Whatever. Gives me something to look forward to later.
Seriously, though, I would love a Battle of the Best game to wrap up the entire series. We get all these... We get the Blade Masters. We get the Awakeners. We just get everybody cool. I need to think.
See
how many
you
certified Blade... Lord, or Divine Blades, I should say. Divine Blades. Are there?
Next time we meet, it will be as enemies.
Yep.
Yep, I know.
Aw.
Aw, I was kind of hoping we'd be able to talk some more. I expect we will have multiple opportunities to do so in the near future.
Yes, we will.
Well, catch you later, Phantom Thief.
Or not. You do know that no one likes your stupid pranks, right?
Tut, tut. There's no need to be so harsh.
Just
it's
saying.
It's a shame we couldn't resume our debate on the nature of beauty this time, my most worthy rival.
I could wax eloquent about beauty till I'm old and gray, but honestly, I think it's about time we settle things between us.
Next time we meet Radiant Blade Master and his daughter, it will be to battle.
Yeah. You don't want any part of
I certainly have no objection to that.
You seem to bear some manner of ill will against my household. I don't know your reasons. But should we be granted the opportunity, I would
I'm sure I could whip your ass without even trying.
Well. Oh, fuck.
Guess that wraps things up for now.
Yep.
You've definitely grown, but you've still got plenty of room for improvement, especially when it comes to piloting Valimar.
Duh.
So unless you're up for another beatdown, I suggest you get to work on fixing that.
Yeah, I know. Oh, and just to confirm, you were the one who told Tovol where I was, right?
Yep, and you helped me with that thing.
2 days ago, I got a call out of nowhere on my Arcus. They gave me this crazy amount of detail on exactly where to find you. Then they just
hung up. They did kind of just sweep that under the rug.
Oh, now that you mention it, he does have the same voice as that mystery caller. I did think he sounded familiar. It must have been because I'd heard it during your concert at the festival.
Yep.
Damn. Looks like the jig is up.
You really did that? Oh, Crow. There's no shame in admitting that you care, you know.
Exactly.
And if I might be so bold as to offer a word of advice.
Yes?
Get Valimar a better sword. One like yours. If you think you're such hot stuff you can beat me without your eight leaves training, you're in for a world of hurt.
Interesting.
Correct choice of opponents is indeed paramount. Selecting both the Awakener is well suited to will increase combat efficiency exponentially.
Now you're just doing this?
I can't pretend to know much about this kind of thing.
He's right. Eastern blades like Maitachi are the heart and soul of the Eight Leaves One Blade style swordsmanship. Mm-hmm. All right, I'll take your advice.
Where?
When I've got myself one, I'll finally take everything back. The Academy, Elise, and even you, Crow.
Really? Really?
If that's how you want it, I'd like to see you try.
Well, I'm sure it will happen. So don't you worry one bit. I'll say, yeah, just forget about your friends. No big deal. Beautifully timed. Hooray! Touchdown!
Courageous! Full speed ahead!
Yes.
Commence retreat from this airspace!
Huh. Tawa! Was that George too? Probably. Okay. Now that we have everybody together, can we please talk about what happened after you sent me away? That sounds like a just event-filled time that I feel like I need to know. Oh yeah, I am being a total nerd, dork, weeb, whatever you want to call me, because I made a separate save file because I want to see the other hot spring scenes with everybody. You all know the one. Forward march zone. So it's going to be interesting to see how all this works out. I mean, this was obvious what was going to happen, but what to do from here, though? That's what I'm interested in seeing. Perhaps Prince Oliver has some sort of plan. Probably does. You're that, or Viscount does.
If that is all, I will return to a state of inactivity.
All right, night-night, Valimar.
Well, you've done, Valimar. I'll be counting on you if anything else comes up.
Indeed.
Prepare yourself for your next encounter with the Astronaut, my
Awakener. Don't worry, I will. We lost last time, but I know that's not all I'm capable of. As long as we're all together,
I think at one point, I don't know if it's right now, we have to go to Roar and get a blade for Valimar. And of course, you know, that's going to be completely easy.
I eagerly await your results.
Looks like he went to sleep.
Yep.
So, this is what the Great Ashen Knight looks like up close, huh?
Truly, isn't it beautiful, Prince Olivier?
I've heard all manner of rumor about it, but I never expected I'd stand in the presence of a legend.
Oh. You've been in plenty of legends before.
Possibly begin to thank you
the enough. Legend of heroes. You are one of those heroes. You've been in both games.
I don't know this what is part I would have done legend. If you hadn't come to my aid. Thank you. Really. And that goes for everyone else, too.
All of you. Big ol' family.
Thanks for coming to rescue me, guys.
We're just happy you're okay.
Just don't scare us like that again, all right?
No promises.
We were all on edge waiting for you to get back.
And yet you somehow managed to come out unscathed with Her Highness in tow.
You make exactly. It sound like it was easy. Well, easy or not, it was worth going on board. I got plenty of useful info
out. We got the most...
So funny enough, the I'd say their invitation worked to my benefit more than theirs.
Information.
I guess there's no harm in looking at the positives now that all's said and done.
Exactly.
Look at you, acting mature and all grown up. Brings a tear to my eye.
Looks like we have some catching up to do.
Get on my level, scrubs.
I'd like to follow Reen's lead and extend my thanks to each of you as well. Thank you, all of you.
Thank you for providing me this opportunity to embrace Lord
and
Mishi.
Dear brother, it's a relief to see you safe and sound. Though I never pictured my great escape would end with you in this airship of all things.
Well, I did.
We did time our appearance fabulously, if I do say so myself.
Yes, you did.
My only regret is that we weren't able to blow in with a storm of rose petals when we boarded them.
Okay, I could see him setting out, like, the front cannons just to be filled up with rose petals for when stuff happens. Just saying. Just saying.
Perhaps I should have asked Emma to look into the feasibility of making such a magnificent entrance.
Yeah, Milliam gets
well,
it.
It's probably not impossible.
Emma's on our side,
no,
too.
Just being silly.
Sounds about right for our prince.
Yep.
Well, at the very least, I'd say we're clear of any immediate danger.
Indeed,
and
Papa
given
said.
This opportunity, I'd like to sit down with you to discuss our situation and exchange any pertinent information. But first, I think we have a few more reunions to celebrate.
Indeed.
Reen!
Toa! George!
Toa! George!
What's up, guys?
I heard your voices when we started flying away from the Pantagruel. So you were on board, too?
Yep.
You bet. Good to see you, Reen.
Oh. She's so adorable. Hug me.
Whoa!
It's really you.
Yep.
You're really okay.
In the flesh.
No sooner had we found out that you were still alive, we got told you had been taken by the Alliance.
Of course.
We've been so, so worried about you.
She's I'm a so real adorable. Troublemaker, aren't I?
Look at her. Look at her. She's adorable.
Sorry, Toa. But I'm glad to see you and George made it out okay. Everything I've said to you has been in the back of my mind ever since we parted ways in Trista. And it's kept me going every step of the way. So, thank you.
Oh. You remembered. You promised me you wouldn't die. And you didn't.
Way to go!
Please,
thank you for breathing.
On that one. But I know you're not the kind of guy who'd go back on his word.
See? Reen's a guy you can count on.
George Gnome.
Nice to see you're holding up okay.
I really appreciated, like, all the
in one piece,
dialogue that these characters had
here you are.
During my second playthrough of Cold Steel 1. Very
Good
well
to
done.
See you again, George.
Yep.
But how'd you two end up on the Courageous to begin with?
We'll bring you up to speed once we all sit down for
Thank
our
meeting. Thank you. Thank you.
There's a conference room on one of the upper floors. We can meet there when you're ready.
Certainly. Wait, do I get to... Do I have free roam? Ooh. Beautiful view. Yes. They are certainly there and definitely not watching porn on their computers. Definitely not. They sure haven't broadcasted it any times.
The Courageous began its independent operations right before Heimdall was first occupied. I realized what the Alliance was planning, so I gathered a skeleton crew, met with Viscount
Arsene. So he got the fuck out of Dodge.
And we hurried straight to Trista, where we found your classmates locked in combat with the Azure Knight.
I see.
Okay, cool.
That explains why you were in Trista.
It's always so nice when he decides to actually talk.
Shudder to think what would have happened if not for the Courageous's timely appearance. What have you been doing since then, Father? I hadn't heard anything about your whereabouts.
Yes,
until
it's
now.
Like we've been on the lam.
Eventually, we were able to shake off the Azure Knight's pursuit. And we've been traveling around the country ever since, preparing to find you and take you on board.
They knew.
George and I haven't been here long.
Oh.
The principal managed to get in touch with the Courageous without anyone noticing and sent us here.
I thought they just kind of were there from the beginning.
I hope he's still all right. By the way, what happened to Major Vander?
Oh, yeah!
You two are always joined at the hip.
Ah, alas, he is currently indisposed. His military obligations have him heading up the 7th Armored Division in Western Erebonia. They're working with your former instructor, Major Nightheart, as well.
Cool.
With him, too? So he's over in the West now.
Let's go stop by and say hi.
I should have known the 4th Armored Division's ace wouldn't get his ass kicked so easily.
Of course.
All right. Dad said he'd heard from him, too, remember?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Still, the west side of the country contains Marquess Higharm Sutherland Province, along with Duke Cayenne's Lemaire Province.
Mm-hmm.
The fighting there would no doubt be even more fierce than it is here in eastern Erebonia.
Correct. A large percentage of the Imperial Army's military strength still remains intact. But the Noble Alliance forces' constant attacks have put them at a disadvantage.
Mm-hmm.
On top of that, a number of townships in the region have been caught in the crossfire and suffered great losses.
That's terrible.
Yeah, it's war.
It hurt as much, but it still pisses me off to hear it.
With the 3rd and 4th Armored Divisions occupied on the eastern side of the country, one can only assume the Noble Alliance intends to use that as an opportunity to crush the forces in the west.
Gotcha.
Yeah, but they're not stupid. I bet the army in the west is putting up a pretty good fight by themselves.
Mm-hmm.
It's too early to call things just yet.
An astute assessment. The situation in the western theater could change at a moment's notice.
Really?
Right. But that means we're uncertain what course to pursue now. And having said that, we have a question to pose to all of you.
Yes.
The question, really.
What are you going to do?
With the whole of the Empire caught in the throes of civil war, what exactly do all of you intend to do from here on out?
Us?
Yes.
We were in the midst of discussing that when Rain was taken to the Pantagruel, in fact.
This is a full-on war, and our fellow Erebonian countrymen stand on both sides.
Mm-hmm.
No one here is delusional enough to think that a group of students like us are capable of stopping it by ourselves. Still, during our field studies, we found ourselves up against the problems this nation faces again and again.
Yes, we know.
And because we have that experience, I believe there's a place for us to change things in all this. A part only we can play.
Guerrilla warfare!
We may not be able to compete head-on with the Alliance, but together, we can move things in the right direction for Erebonia as a whole.
So, what, are we inducing a stalemate?
That was wonderful, Reen.
Still, we aren't all gathered here for the same reasons.
Quite.
Be it rescuing Elise or settling things with Crow, we've all got some.
Both use though your thing.
But accomplishing those things won't be possible with the situation as it stands. And that's why, no matter how stacked the odds are against us, or how fierce the fighting becomes...
Yes?
We want to put everything we have into making all the difference we possibly can, in whatever way we can.
Hooray!
I think I speak for everyone in Class 7 when I say that.
You just danced around the...
You bet.
...question.
I agree completely. We may all come from different walks of life, but this time, that can work for us.
It's like it's sort of planned or something.
We have something no one else does, and because of that, we can do things no one else can.
And what kind of class would we be if we didn't take advantage of that to protect the people and things we love?
As well as find our own answers to the questions we have looming over us.
As Reen said,
it's a win all around.
It is in the long run. We have a place in this war, and we have every intention of following it.
Sounds like it'll be a pain, though.
Yep.
No biggie. We're class 7. Throw in a few of Reen's trademark speeches and we're
raring
to go.
There we go.
Kids.
You all sound like you've really thought long and hard about this.
Giggity.
That's the class 7 I'm proud to serve.
And you guys aren't the only ones who feel that way.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone at Thors has something to bring to the table.
Exactly.
Remember the Academy's motto? Arise, O youth, and become the foundation of the world.
Yes, it was beautiful.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That was what Principal Van Dyke said to us at the welcoming ceremony.
And it's Dreykul's favorite say.
The words of Dreykul's the Lionheart serve to inspire us to this day, it would seem.
And it's something that still needs to be done to this day.
Of course. They ring as true as ever.
We are the future, people. We need to step up and take their responsibility.
You guys just knew.
Get the world to stop sucking so badly.
Yeah, you should be proud of yourselves. And it's true that Thor students are scattered all over the country right now.
And we've bumped
but
into
I'm
a
sure
few.
That each and every one of them are
ooh
fighting too. And they
can it be a side quest to reunite
way that you
like
guys do
all the Thor's characters that they have scattered in
I
the
understand
world?
Your Highness.
Obviously, it's indeed not going to be every single one.
I figured
one, but
you would have already given it some thought, but I wasn't expecting such a stirring conviction. But I think this at least settles the matter of what course to take. If you would do the honors, Captain.
We hereby find you in treason of the country.
As you wish. We're about to do something neither side would ever expect us to do. We're going to entrust this ship to you. From here on out, the courageous
hooray
is yours to command as you
I
see fit.
I got... wait. When did this turn into Final Fantasy? I have an airship. Don't get me wrong, I'm
what
excited about it, but I have an airship.
What?
That is so cool. Yes, thank you, Elliot.
Father, would you mind elaborating?
It means exactly what it sounds like.
Yep.
The operation of this ship will be left entirely to your discretion.
Hooray!
I imagine your journey to make a difference in this war needs a home base to begin from.
Ymir!
Well, yes, but...
but then what will you do?
We plan to disembark and make our way to the Western Provinces.
Oh.
Once there, we'll begin working with the 7th Armored Division and the other neutral forces in the region.
Nice.
The intention is to ensure that as few innocents as possible are harmed by this conflict.
Cool.
I was actually worried this airship might prove a bit too conspicuous to aid us in pursuing that goal. But with us headed west, we'd be leaving
nice
all of Eastern Erebonia in your hands.
Got it, dudes.
Wow.
Yeah. Don't worry. You can take a moment if you need to clear the shit from your pants, Reed. We all understand.
I see. That does make the most logical sense.
We got an airship.
We
got an airship.
We could give our third faction some real weight. Neither side could afford to ignore us.
Exactly.
I'm not even sure the guild could come up with a plan this wild.
Oh, yes, they could have.
Well, it's fair to say I've learned a lot from the way the guild's members handle things, yourself included. Oh, and Alfin?
Yes?
You are to stay aboard with Reen.
I'd like to ask you to remain
oh
on
cool
board the Courageous as well.
Called it.
This ship is technically the property of the Arnor household, fathers in particular. It should give them a certain freedom to act if they have concrete backing from a member of the Imperial family.
Nice. She believes in this one.
I'd be happy to.
It's not like what she was doing.
Princess Alfin Rysay Arnor will guarantee the legitimacy of their actions.
Hooray!
So do whatever you see fit to do. You have my full support.
Yes, and Lord Mishi approves as well.
Thank you, Your Highness.
Well,
we're truly honored to have you with us.
Nice.
No turning back now.
Yeah, seriously.
So we have a motherfucking airship. This is cool. I can get behind this.
Yay! Courageous.
Please, leave Eastern Erebonia to us.
We've got this.
We'll be counting on you then.
I'm looking forward to toasting your future successes.
Yep, and we'll be by at the end of the game, just when you need us the most. Probably. On that day, Class 7 was entrusted with the day-to-day running of the Courageous. Viscount Arsaid and Prince Olive decided that they would disembark near Le Graham, travel to western Erebonia across the lake. And after receiving the bare minimum instructions on how to operate the ship, its bright-eyed new owner set course for Apple Highway. Guys, do you, maybe think you should have told them how it works? Just throwing that out there as a possibility.
You gonna land for us, please?
Now loading, yes.
I'm leaving you in charge of the Courageous's day-to-day operations.
Admit it, Viscount. You just like the hat because it looked cool on you, and it's gonna look adorable on her.
I don't doubt you'll make a fine acting captain.
It would be an honor.
Acting Captain Toa. It suits her. Aww. You look fantastic. It really does suit her.
Yeah, the size is just right too.
Fortunately, I had a spare on hand that was a size smaller.
I was quite fortunate.
You look like a kind of new mascot, like a human Mishi. Perhaps we should capitalize on this opportunity with an irresistible line of Captain Toa merchandise. Yes, please, please, I would buy.
Oh, you two are terrible.
That's like a nice touch though, it suits you.
Yep, you definitely look the part of a captain with it. I think things will be just fine in our absence.
Oh. All the grown-ups are going away. Please leave Tits with us. Please. Okay, so they're all headed west. And she's heading to the RMP. Sharon? What about you?
Been entrusted with a number of research tests by Chairman Arena, as it happens, so this is farewell for now. That doesn't sound shady at all. But stay safe, alright? Whether you're a member of Ouroboros or not, I'll never change that you're our family maid. Oh my. Touch to hear you say so. Please, my lady, take care of yourself.
Keep in touch, okay? Keep gathering as much info as I can through the Guild's intelligent network. It's not like Erebonia is the only place where strange stuff's going down now. Really? Oh yeah, Crossbell. I thought it was like somewhere else, like Calvard or Liberal.
Thanks for everything you've done for us. Sure, we wouldn't have been able to come this far if not for your help.
No need to get all stiff all of a sudden. You're embarrassing me.
We may be working separately from now on, but I tend to do all I can to aid you in the future. Take care, everyone.
Master Reed, would you mind accepting this?
What is it?
It's a little something I've always kept with me.
Oh.
I hope it will be of some use to you.
Oh. Thank you. Thank you, Sharon. You're always taking care of us, you know that? I wish you could just stay with us a little longer. Feels like I have so much more I could learn from you.
I would like to remain here and continue to serve you as well.
Yes, you would like to serve me.
I wish you the very best in the days to come. I'm sure that if you try, you will find a place worthy of you in this world.
Yes, whatever that may be.
I also hope that you'll continue to care for Lady Elisa in more ways than one.
Really now? Sharon, stop. We'll take care of her while you're away, so don't worry.
Well then, it's time we bid you all a fond farewell for now. Chin up, Alfin. I'm counting on your charm to keep everyone motivated.
May the goddess be with you.
Yay! Lord Mishi is right there with her.
I look forward to the stories you'll have to tell when next we meet, Laura.
Hooray!
Good luck, Father.
We'll have many adventures to tell. Many shenanigans going on. Okay, as soon as the adults go away, Let's just have a huge party. Sarah, you can get us the booze, right? Yeah.
Well, there they go. You think they'll be okay on their own?
Yep.
Only the goddess herself knows for certain.
Still, with some already calling this a second advent of the War of the Lions.
Yep.
I can only hope they make it through unscathed.
Oh, they'll be fine.
Sure
don't worry about it.
I'll be just fine. They don't bear the symbol of the horned lion for show.
Yes, I suppose you're right.
Yes,
and
yes.
And the same goes for me, too. I can't very well call myself a Thor's alumnus and fail to deliver.
Exactly. You all shall be spreading Lord Mishi's influence across the land.
Well, well, are we birds of a feather? Proud Thor's graduates unite. I'll be in touch with them plenty
it's
in
so
the coming weeks, so don't worry. The old guard
interesting
must do as it must to keep
to
watching the young and vigilant.
Oliver actually behave himself instead of how ridiculous he was acting
Speaking
in liberal.
Speaking of the old guard, Chancellor Osborne was also a Thor's graduate, was he not?
Yep.
Yes, he was.
Sorry to say, I can't.
Yeah, how
it.
Old is that dude?
Was he now?
He and I may have had our differences, but I still feel a certain.
He
loss
still has. Time. There's a lot of his character or what he's been up to that
I'd
we
like
still
to
don't
express
know.
My condolences to you while I have the
like,
chance.
What the fuck? Milliam's a part
I'm
of.
I'm afraid I never had the chance to truly get to know him. But there's no doubt in my mind that he was one of the greatest men of our time.
Thank you.
Aww.
Still, it must be tough for you with Heimdall under the Alliance's thumb. Were you able to find out where his funeral was held?
Actually...
Have they not had it yet? Is he alive?
Captain?
Is something amiss?
It's just that... I received a strange report on that very issue.
Mm-hmm.
I was told his body was taken into the custody of the Imperial Guardsmen when the city was occupied.
Yes.
But then after that, it simply disappeared at some point.
Huh.
Disappeared, you say?
Is it possible the reformist faction could have taken
nope.
it from there?
He's just up and about.
I'm afraid I don't know.
A simple bullet to the heart
it
wasn't enough to
kill him. That the intelligence division did something to that effect.
Or, no, but it did seem like he honestly got beat by Crow.
It's difficult not to draw parallels with the Lance Maiden's sudden death following the War of the Lions.
Unbelievable. I'm almost impressed how much trouble one man can stir up, even from beyond the grave.
He might not be dead. Just saying.
So many plots in motion. I doubt even his death put a stop to them all.
Of course you would have the just plain black screen when you say this. Do we have to deal with all that shit now? Probably. Yeah, definitely. Touring Erebonia 1. Yeah. Got myself a nice little airship. Kind of looks like a boot. But oh well. It's my boot. It's my flying boot of majesty. Of beauty. Yes, yes. It's all very nice. No change in the weather or wind direction since entering Karuzan Province airspace. We're currently cruising at speeds of 3,000 SPH. Nothing abnormal detected on the radar thus far. Detour around the Twin Dragons Bridge, staying within the clouds. Take extra care that we aren't noticed by the Noble's Alliance surveillance.
Yes, ma'am.
Wow, she's real natural at this. Yeah, it's hard to believe she's only been in position for a day. Indeed, she has proved worthy captain in father's place. Anyone could fit the role better than our student council president. She looks like a mascot character, though. That's just one of her many charms. Oh, come on. It's a toss-up between her and Milliam. And of course, you know, Lord Mishi. So today's the day we start our journey anew, right? Right. We settled what we've been doing last night. Now we're anxious to do so. Where are we headed? Well, Tellor and Joe should be able to handle day-to-day running of the ship, so that's out of the way.
whatever we decide, it's not like we're going to be able to do anything majors today. Still, I think it's time we start hammering down what exactly we're going to do from today onward. In theory, the Courageous gives us the ability to fly around the whole country with ease. But in reality, the Noble Alliance has control over most of Erebonia, so we're just limited in where we can actually go. We don't want to risk getting too close to Alliance territory. We'd run the risk of being captured, or even worse, being shot down. It's sad to think we barely have anywhere we can land with an amazing airship like this at our disposal. Care to share your thoughts on this, Instructor? Oh, you kids can just do whatever you want. I've lost the will to put in any thought after Captain Classy got off. You slacker. I'm pleased that you think so highly of my father, but...
Stay away from him!
Maybe Laura can hook up. You a one-on-one lecture with the Arcade School of Courtsmanship, if you know what I'm saying. I was kidding. All seriousness, if you end up needing more people fighting, you know, whatever, up doing, I'll be happy to help you out. So don't forget that the Courageous is entrusted to you kids, not to me. If you want my advice, then you got it. But you need to be able to make your important decisions on your own. Of course! You almost sound like an instructor for once. Getting back to the matter at hand, we don't need to decide everything right at this moment. What do you say figure out the how and what? Come again? Assuming the what would be our rival goal, something realistic that we can all work towards. And the how is a basic idea of how we intend to achieve it? Uh-huh. Bill check we use in student council. It's easier to get motivated when you have a specific goal in mind. You guys are doing the same kind of thing in the weeks before the Academy Festival, remember? Concert that was what you're working towards. And how your other planning was how you intend to pull it off. I see, that makes sense. You did spend a lot of time before and during the festival working out all the details, come to think of it. Not to mention taking care of things we couldn't plan, like strange stuff at the schoolhouse. We were coordinating with all the other classes and clubs at the same time, too. When you break it down step by step, we did so much without even realizing it. We may have our own personal goals right now, but if we wrap up those into an overarching goal, it won't be that bad. How about making it something related to the Academy itself, then? I was thinking the exact same thing. I wonder what's happening there. Yeah, what exactly happened? Tawa, George. The Academy is currently under Noble Alliance control, right? That's right. Staff and students who are there are doing what they can, but... So you know, during the attack, a lot of the students managed to flee Trissa, now scattered across the country. Most upper-class students chose to stick it out, though. They've got no reason to fear the Alliance, being nobles and all. Alright then. I think our what should be taking back the Academy. Sounds good to me. Courageous will serve as good means of transport, but we'll need a proper base sooner or later. But with it, we can get a better look at the current state of the things in Erebonia and try to reach out to those who are in need.
And whatever information we learn along the way could bring us that much closer to liberating the Academy.
Can't see it taking back being that smoothly, though. No doubt, it's near the capital, so its defenses are going to be rock solid. Still, I like it. What goal is more worthy of us reclaiming than something we hold so dear? Indeed, regardless of personal motivations, I can't think of an objective more fitting to us as a group. If they actually manage to achieve it, the sky's the limit for us. Gently moved by your positivity. Well, their optimism is probably their strongest point. We're thinking something along the same lines, in fact, so it works out. Hey, if we all thought about it, what's to stop others from Thor thinking about it too? If you happen to bump into anyone who escaped from the Academy, why not ask them to join us? Yes! I'm not saying it has to be your primary focus or anything, but the more people we have on the side, the better. It's a great idea. Be sure to keep an eye out. We have about the bare minimum crew we need to fly at the moment, but it's not like this is their full-time job. I'm sure our current staff won't be here forever, so we're going to need a few extra hands on board at some point. Ideally, we could have whoever's here stick around long enough to train anyone we end up recruiting. I know our numbers are small right now. The more people we get on the side, the higher chance we have of making Trista and the Academy our home again. I don't know about you, but I get this weird sense of satisfaction knowing that these students are going to be the ones to do it. I know the feeling, actually. Everything works for me. Say, that's our how decided, wouldn't you? Agreed. To wrap this up, we'll use the Courageous as our base and good idea of the current state and things in Eastern Erebonia. Along the way, we'll try to recruit many Thor students who help us out, all for the sake of our primary goal, taking back Thor's Military Academy. Hooray! Oh, God. Please. Please. Well, I suppose we need to decide is where we should head to first. You don't have many places we can get to at the moment, but there's the Gram, Ymir, the Nords. We will land the 4th Armored Division, too, right? Yeah, I asked Dad about it yesterday, and he's fine with it. Probably better for us to go swing by all of them at once, really. Oh, almost forgot. Prince Olivert sent you a few requests to take care of. He did? Oh, joy. The details are right behind you. Behind us? Oh, there's a normal computer here. Why would we really use this in one class? No need to fear. Technology doesn't bite. Plus, it's easier than a long run for you to grab stuff from it. So go on, take a look. Sure. Give me my list. Oh, lucky us. These are made by the Epstein Foundation, so they're identical to the ones we use in class. Oh, being serious. I thought she was... My bad. Something popped up. This is how everything's displayed. Intelligent Vision has some of these, too. Without leave. Something had to be taken to a custody. Cool. Badass in danger. Cargo.
Party's in trouble.
She's in trouble. Those damn noble soldiers. Okay. Find our first years. Gotcha. And monster madness. Large mysterious monsters appeared in the highlands. Huh. Interesting. So I'm going... Do I have free movement? Yep. I think it's fine. He is impressive. He just left for Western Airbone. He's good. These guys have plenty of connections, especially through the Bracer Guild. So he's gonna keep finding stuff like this he thinks you can handle and send them your way. How many he ended up doing is up to you, but I'd recommend taking care of the more urgent ones at least. Understood, I don't think any of us mind one bit. Indeed, helps focus our goal touring the region, helping those in need. That being said, I would assume checking the safety of our fellow Thor students is our top priority. I took the liberty of giving you that one myself. We're getting information on whether other students are. Anytime we find something, we'll update the computer. Who knows? Maybe they'll be willing to join us too. How convenient. Very grateful for those glasses. Guess we'll be checking this pretty often then. I think that's almost everything. When you decide where you want to go first, let me know, okay? Oh, and George's hard work finishing up the Obel factory. Yay! So if you need any modification to your Arcus or any quartz, you can sort those out there. While you're at it, it's worth checking out the other facilities on board too. It's not much while we're short on staff, but I'm sure any students you recruit will get creative with their space. Might as well. Still, you guys mind if you figure out who's going to be making up the active party when we first disembark? Actually, if we're doing that, would you mind including me? I'd like to see the strange monster from the Highlands at my request. Don't mind at all. Sounds fair. Yes! You just let me know if I'm needed, okay? Thanks, instructor. Let's see. Gotcha. So... Tits, Laura, Elliot, Emma. Looks good to me! Okay, let's get going. Right.
Let's go, go, go!
Yes, Milliam. We shall. Please. Please. I need to end this episode. It's been going on forever now. I do the instructor amends. Tour the facilities. Yeah, go see George and pay Valimar a visit. Maybe go see Princess Alphen too. Oh, cool. And... Freedom! Okay, I am ending this episode here. God damn, a lot of shit happened. Anyhow, thank you guys for watching, and thanks for staying weird.